once again some of the television programs, you can say, and we can say that a new program, that not new program, in fact, the iterations method, iter rows to be used out here. That how to use that, we will see that today. Okay, so we are going to the programs right now. So first of all, this particular program, you are well familiar with the programs data frame. Okay, so to create a data frame and add a column, that's very simple program. Here what happens, here the thing is that it says, this is the existing data frame. Okay, and here the dictionary object has been passed. Okay, that usual how what you do actually while creating a data frame. Fine. So now the thing is that this student's PR percent, that's to be added instead of previous along with this previous percentage also. Means like you can say this one as present percentage. All right. Now the thing is that this is the PR percent has been taken. Okay, and these students, it has been added. Okay, then updated data frame has been printed out here. And here what we have done, this particular thing, the names, okay, I will just remove this one, I can do it later on also. All right, so this is actually df1.drop, that is actually to remove it, removal of a column that I have shown you previously. Okay, how it looks like, okay, and how it is to do. And finally, that whenever you are for index row in df1, iter rows function is the one that actually creates an iteration, means repetition, as long as the data frame data are existing. All right, so it will take in this way, that is a single unit, it will be taking Amit, age is 18 and previous percentage is 78.0. okay, in that way it will be taking, if the previous percentage has been dropped, in the test PR percent will be taken. Fine. So means like 45.6 will be taken, and this particular record will have the index 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. All right, so in this way, so it is actually iter rows. What it does actually, it is doing the iteration among the rows in a data frame. Fine. So now let us execute this program and see what the output has been generated by the program itself. Click on OK. Fine. Next, what has been done? Yes, the output will be expecting within few seconds. Okay, so what it will be there? So first of all, we will see here, as the, we have created the data frame. So first of all, the data frame, original data frame, will be printed. Okay, it has been appeared out here. So now see bit bigger output this one is actually. You know, this is the original data frame has been printed up to print df1. Okay, fine here. Okay, then you see the PR percent has been added out here. How I have been added, this one you can see out here is the dictionary name has been taken, and the PR percent, this particular option has been taken. All right, and then what else has been taken? df1 period of data frame students. Okay, print df1 means like updated data frame has been printed along with the row that has been added. Now we are going to the previous percentage to be removed. Okay, PREB_PRC to be removed. So it has been removed over here by using the drop function, and in place has been kept true. So previously also I had told you that whenever you are deleting a particular column, so in that case what you have to do is you have to use the in place =2, otherwise no effect will take place for this particular job, you know. Okay, that is the thing. So afterwards you are printing the updated data frame. Same thing happened out here. Now the next part, the iter rows part, is coming. You see out here when it has been taken, the zero names Amit. Okay, names is the key value, and then Amit is the value. This is the key, this is the value. Here again the age has been come, that is 18, and as previous percentage is not available, that's why this PR percent is appearing with 45.6. so this is one thing has been completed in this way. Zero index the first record, then the second record, then the third record, fourth record, fifth record, all this way it is increasing. Okay, that is the thing. So if you are giving in this way, suppose can do an experiment out here. So if I'm giving index +1, then let's see what happens. I'm closing this one once more. Okay, then see if any numerical operation is available out there or not. Let us see. No, it is not. Okay, so now you see the thing is that I have done in this way. So what I have done in this way, you will understand it right now. Okay, so it has been appearing. Now you see, as I have done index index +1, it is appearing from 1. Okay, that time it was appearing with 0. As I have done index +1, then it is showing 0 plus 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The usual things will happen now. Okay, that is the things. That is the default setting actually. So there are total 11 records and it is starting from 1 to 11. But when it was indexed, it was just simply from 0 to 10. That is the 11 data. So now we can understand easily that what is happening in the eta_rows function. While you have used the eta_rows function, it is starting from 1. Rest of the things are all right. So here the addition of the column takes place, here the deletion of the column takes place, and here the iteration of the columns in a data frame takes place. Fine. So that is the way to use the eta_rows function in a data frame. All right. That is very, very important, you know. So you must do this particular program, practice this program, as well as do its practical implementation. Then definitely it will give you a certain certain advantage while doing the data frame column. Okay, and I can write out here iteration of rows. So what is the command? Iterrows. Okay, that is the function which will help us to iterate a particular data frame. So row in data df1 iterrows, that is the best option to do it. And index plus one, you have done it, because otherwise it will start the first index, that is from zero. The first record will be zero, which is not sometimes user may misjudge it. That's why we have given it index plus one. So it will start from 1 to 11. That means 11 records are there in this data frame which has been added, which has been iterated. Okay, sorry, which have been iterated. All right, that is the thing. So this is the purpose of this particular iteros function. So you must go through it and do its practical implementation. All right. Okay, so now we're going to the another interesting program, that is how to do the string manipulation out here. Okay, how to rename the columns. All right, how to rename the columns of the student. So what we will do actually, here the columns to be renamed. Okay, so the name will be changed into students. Okay, sorry, I forgot to put E out here. Yes, E, students. All right, so the thing is that data frame has been taken out. Okay, so always you practice with a different data frame, values in dictionary. Okay, here so you can add one more column out here, that is there. Okay, and then this rename function will be used in this format only. What is the syntax? Then data frame object dot rename equals to columns, within bracket columns equals to, first only the old column name will come, then the new column name will come. That means here names is going to be renamed into students. All right, so that's what. So now let's see how it could be done. Then run, I'm doing run module out here. All right, and then clicking on okay. Now you check out how this thing takes place. So the output will be appearing within a few seconds. So this particular thing is very easy to understand. This name simply will be changed into students. You can see out here, this names has been renamed into students. A very distinct program and very clean program, very easy to understand at the same time. All right, so that's what the renaming has been taken place in this particular program. Okay. And this df1 the period of data frame, as you will understand that this one has been dictionary has been passed as a data frame object, and the data frame, original data frame, has been printed out here, and finally the renamed one has been printed in this way. So that is the students has been names has been changed into students. All right, this program is also very important for you. Okay, that is actually showing you, describing you how to rename a particular column. All right, so see the program once more nicely for a few seconds. You can see out here how this has been done. Okay, how this has been done. Yes, this is the particular program. All right, to create a data frame, that is the remark has been given, usual data frame and renaming a column. Just I'm giving the remark and renaming a column. Okay, that is the demonstration of the renaming of column in a dictionary. All right, so that is the thing. So now we are coming to the another program. Okay, this is also very easy to understand. Okay, when you, the same thing we are doing, but here the multiple columns, renaming of multiple columns has been taken place. So what does it do? why this program is so important that sometimes the outputs will be given to you, so you have to generate this kind of things, or sometimes maybe the direct questions will be given, a data frame structure will be given, then from that particular structure they will tell you, ask you to do this changes. All right, in that particular program, first of all create a data frame, then they might say that rename these columns, all right, and finally they will say that create an iteration of this, delete this column. So a data frame, a structure can be given, and from there different type of questions can be framed. All right, so that is the thing. So this is the multiple columns, that means colors and shapes. This is the original data frame. Now when renaming, what is happening, colors will change into shapes and shapes into will be changed into colors. You see out here it has been given in a not in appropriate mode. Colors has been given where the shapes are being described, and the shapes has been given when the colors have been described. So what we are doing actually, we are taking the shapes into the place of color, and colors which taken into the place of shapes. So in this way, that is the format. Okay, so the key value, so the old name and the column name, and in between there will be a colon, and when the multiple columns you are talking about, in that case a comma to be used in between. Now you watch the output very carefully. I am executing this program for you. Okay, all right, let's see, it will come. So, and students, one more thing to tell you, that whenever you are doing this, you are watching this YouTube videos and all other video tutorials available with you, so what would you do is this, when listening this one, pause it and then read the program properly and then go through, because program is static on your screen for certain seconds. All right, that's the things. Okay, so you can note it down in that particular course of time. Now you see, it's quite rightly said that colors and shapes has been printed out here. Colors, the triangles and square, and shapes, red, blue, green, all the things have come. But here the shapes has been coming over here first. That is the colors has been shifted over there. So the multiple column renaming will take place in this way, whatever be the dictionary or the shape of the dictionary or whatsoever. Okay, so it can be changed in this way. Clear? That is the thing. So this way, when you will do this kind of programs, only the thing is that you have to remember the syntax. If you don't know the, if you cannot remember the syntax, then in that case you'll be in trouble. Okay, so the accurate things will not happen. All right, so what is the format? Once again, data frame df equals to df, the data frame object dot rename within bracket columns equals to, then the column names that to be renamed. When we are putting the column names, then first of all the old column name, then the new column names will take place, then the old column name, then the new column names will take place, and so on. Okay, if you need to rename, rename some more columns, that also will be added by using a comma, but that to be given within a pair of curly braces. Okay, and rename will be enclosed within a pair of parentheses. All right, that's what this particular program is actually being described. All right, out here. Okay, so that's the thing. So now next we'll move into another program. This one you have seen already, how this things has been taken place, renaming of the single column. Now another program is there that is also very simple. Okay, so there is simply the output based program. Okay, so you can see out here the programs for seconds or for few seconds, and then simple. Okay, up to data frame creation is not a problem. Okay, data frame creation you can do it. Okay, after that the renaming, deletion, addition, all these things you have to remember, and for the iteration even. Okay, how this thing has been taken place, you have to do it in the same manner. All right, so what is happening out here, a simple dictionary has been created. Okay, a simple dictionary has been created, and this dictionary while created, okay, df1 dot period of data frame students, creation of a data frame object by passing a dictionary, print df1, df1 names, str.upper.head3. So here the head and tail command also has been described. So I'm just removing for the sake of understanding this one first of all. Okay, then the thing is that, so let us tell me that what is the upper is doing. Upper is actually changing the names, all the names into the uppercase, as you understand, and lower will change all the names in lowercase. So here it is not appearing in either in upper or lowercase entirely. How it is appearing? It is appearing in a mixed, in the proper case. You can say that as we write, whenever we are writing a name, the first letter we keep capital and the rest of the letters we are keeping in small. Okay, that is the usual way of writing. And here what we are doing, here we are changing the names into uppercase and we are changing in the names into lowercase. All right. So the thing is that first without head we are doing, then I will show you without without tail, with head and tail. Okay, the function also to be described once more. Okay, that is the thing. So now I am executing this program in the run module. Okay, then clicking on OK. Fine. Now let us see what is happening out here. Okay, so this has been printed. You can see, watch it very carefully. Okay, so the thing, this is the entered data frame. You see the names has been printed in capitals, in all caps, and here it has been printed in all in small letters. Okay, all in small letters. You can see out here, all in small letter. All right. Now we are coming to the head and tail. And what is the things? Dot tail. I'm giving out here dot tail and then open close brackets. All right. And then here also we are doing dot head and then open close brackets. Fine. So now what is happening? You see, run module. Okay, clicking on OK, and we will get the output right now. All right. So you see now what has been happened out here. The head and tail. So what is happening? Head, the function of head from the output, it is quite clear. If you don't give any argument means within this parenthesis, if you are not passing any argument, in that case what will happen? Head will print the first five records. Okay, 0 1 2 3 4, that has been printed. And tail will print last five records. Okay, whatever be the things. That means if you are having 100 records, then from 0 to 4 will be printed for head if you don't pass anything, and for tail it will be printed like 96 to 100 97 98 99 and 100, five records from the end. So that is the purpose, that is the normally it does. Okay, now the thing is that here what we are doing, we are just changing a bit this one. We are making it 3 and we are making it out here also, not 3, we are making it out here 2. Okay, now we are executing this program. Now you see how the things has been taken place. Okay, I'm clicking on OK out here. Okay, see the change in output. Yes. Now you see previously 5 and 5 it was there, but as we have passed an argument with a head command, then what is happening? First 3 records are coming, since 3 has been passed to head, and then 2 has been printed from the end. That is, Dugesh has been printed out here in small letters, but this is the multiple uses. Okay, you know, that is the STL lower dot tail dot 2. Okay, then Dugesh and Nila has been printed. Okay, so what is the thing? So from the end, 2 records has been printed. So in this way, if we are using the head and tail function, what happens? You can change the number of records from its default settings, okay, into as per your requirement. Okay, so first three records has been shown, and last 2 records has been shown, and you have passed 3 within head and then tail, and 2 within tail. All right, that's the thing. So these are all about the head and tail function. So what can you do? You can easily execute this kind of programs, and you can practice this kind of programs as well. Whenever you are practicing or implementing practicals, you can take separate data. And this, when you practice and you write the programs, definitely you will have a good grip on programming, that I must say. All right, but if you are not practicing, you will forget. Okay, you have seen, once you have seen, I understood that you understand everything. But the thing is that if you are not repeating it, and within a short course of time, you will definitely forget everything. So that's why a regular practice is very much required, and you do it regularly. All right. Thank you.